Welcome everybody to today's video where I will be reviewing the Kellor. Is it Kellor? Actually might be color, just as in the word color. Soft pastel pencils. And I apologize, my voice is a little bit weird because I've had COVID the last few weeks. So yeah, I'm just still recovering, but I'm getting a lot better. Anyway, I have used these pencils one other time when I drew my cat Trixie. I didn't do that as a video. It was just a quick test. It took me about 2 hours to draw Trixie, and it was the only time I've ever used pastels. And it's the only time I've ever drawn a picture of an animal. But today I'm going to be doing this adorable red panda that I got the picture from Pixels. And yeah, I think it's going to be a lot of fun because I've seen some amazing artwork like on social media where people draw animals and they get the most realistic looking pictures because they've used pastels, and I would have not expected that because pastels to me are very chalky, but they get these remarkable beautiful details and everything always looks amazing, so it made me want to try them. So yeah, this is my first go at pastel pencils and I'm just going to have fun and really just try to enjoy these and see how it all goes. It will be interesting to see how these pencils actually work out because, number one, they are amongst the cheapest in the pastel range. They're not light fast, so the work will fade over time, but I'm just testing these. It doesn't really matter. I'm not going to exactly have this piece hanging in a museum for like hundreds of years. I'm probably going to put it in my folio, and once it's in my folio, it's going to pretty much stay there and I'll have it as a reference. And because it will be out of the light, it's not going to fade, hopefully. So I think it'll be fine. I was actually finding the pastels are actually really interesting to use because the paper itself, which is pastel matte, is designed for pastel pencils. It's like sandpaper, but it's like that sandpaper that you touch and almost feels smooth because the teeth in the sandpaper, or in this paper, in the pastel paper, are so fine and they absorb all of the pastels. So when you use the pastel, you have to sharpen them a lot because it wears down very quickly because all of the pigment goes into these little tubes, these little teeth. But I found that it's kind of like, it's going to sound weird, but it's actually a little bit like oil paint. And I know oil paint is completely the opposite of a dry medium, but you kind of put a color down and then if you want to blend colors, you just put another color on top. And then what happens is you can then get like a blending tool of some kind and you just start blending it and it fills in all the grooves and you actually mix all the colors this way. So even when the colors are a little bit not really what you want, the fact that you can actually blend it really, really easily on the actual piece is so awesome. And that's why it reminds me of oil painting, because you don't necessarily have to do it on a palette like you would any other kind of paint. You just do it on the actual piece. And I really, really liked that. I was kind of worried because the colors are really vibrant that are in this packet. And like, I didn't really want these bright reds and oranges. I really wanted something more muted because that would be more reflecting the actual color of the fur. But because of the blending and the fact that all of those little pigments are just tiny, fine little powders that are on the paper and they blend really well, you really can tone the colors up or down and do what you really want with them. That even if you don't have a specific color, there's enough selection in this 50 pack that you can pretty much make any color you want. Obviously people always say you can always make colors with the three primaries, but I didn't have to do a lot of work to do that. You don't want to obviously have to use too many pencils or, you know, too many colors. Once the grooves actually start to, the little teeth start to fill up, you can't really lay down too much color after that, but I was able to get a lot of layers in. One of the things you can also do is I haven't actually tried this, but pastels will not go over the top of normal color pencils, normal wax or oil-based pencils. So I have a feeling that you probably could actually put down a color, like a white down, and actually mask an area. So that way, once you come in with the pastels, it will not go into that area, just because the wax will fill up the teeth and there's nothing for the pastel to hold onto. I actually didn't do that. I'm not really experienced enough with animal drawings. I think some people that'd be far more experienced than me probably could do that. I do come in later in the drawing with my white pencil, and I do add some details because you can use a normal pencil on top of pastel, you just can't do it the other way around. As a beginner to pastels and a beginner to animal drawings, I'm actually really happy how my little red panda is turning out. The blending of the fur actually kind of looks like fur. Like I really just like it. Like these pencils are so easy. Some people don't like the texture of it because they're on a rough surface. Some people just don't like touching certain things, but I actually found it really enjoyable. I really, really like the pastels, and this drawing only took me an hour and a half to do. Like, that is ridiculously a short amount of time for something that I think actually looks quite good. Like, there would be people that can draw far better than me with this medium, but as a newbie to pastels and as a newbie to animal drawings, I thought these pencils were really, really user-friendly. I think they're really great for a beginner because you can actually do something like this in an hour and a half and actually have something that you're really proud of. Unlike most color pencils that will take, like most color pencil pictures that will probably take you hours and hours to kind of do something similar. And here I am putting some details in. I used my Wax Space white pencil. As I said, you can use that over the top. And the only thing I don't like about this is I wish I actually had a sharper point on that pencil because the whiskers look a little bit fat. But you know what? It's all learning and sometimes you make mistakes. Anyway, that is it for today's video. Don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. I will see you next time. Bye.